Very good afternoon, all the students. Today we will see the practical number 2, that is the numerical based on the Kani's method. So as shown on the screen, it is a practical number 3, but as it is a type number 2, so we will treat it as a practical 2. Okay, so as shown on the screen, this is a unequal leg portal frame having a horizontal load of P is applied at the joint B and a W load is acting at the center of the span BC. So we have to analyze this frame by using Kani's method. Okay, and also we have to validate this numerical with STAD. So today I will show you how to model this frame in a STAT Pro and how to get the final output in the form of bending moment and shear force. And it is your as assignment that you have to solve this numerical as a manual calculation in your practical copy. Okay, so first of all you have to see that how I will going to model this numerical instead and how the final output, that is bending moment and shear force, will be calculated. Okay, so in your practical copy, first of all you have to solve this numerical as a manually and you have to get the final result in the form of bending moment and shear force. Okay, and then you have to model your numerical in STAT. Okay, because unless and until you are not getting your final output in the form of bending moment and shear force manually, you will not going to compare this final output with STAT. Okay, so let us see that. I will solve the numerical number, the case number 1 for you. Okay, so let us see that how to solve this numerical in STAT Pro. Okay, so this is the geometry of the structure. Okay, so P is given as P. So first of all we have to consider P as 5 meter. Okay, P we have to consider 5 meter in our model. Okay, then we have consider the load as 10 kilonewton. Okay, and the length of the span is 5 meter. So this case I will going to solve in STAT. Okay, and I will consider the uniform I value for all the span, that is for AB, BC and CD. Okay, and let us see that. So first of all in STAT you have to open the STAT, go to the new project, then click on space, then you have to check very carefully the length unit as in meter and force unit is in kilonewton meter, then the storage location you can change according to your storage. So let us name that file number 2 as a practical number 2 is there. Then we have to consider the directories from where we have to store. So I will store in this removable disk. Under this SA2 is there, under this practicals is there, under this 2 is there. So under this I will going to store my STAT file, then go to next, go to add beam is already mark, then go to finish. So the structure is look like this. Okay, so first of all we have to work on exact plane. So we have to define the grid in exact plane. So just go to create, go to exact plane, named it as either A, B, C, D or whatever you want. Okay, then click OK, then go to this. Always start your model from the 0,0 point. Okay, so let us see. So here A to B. We have to go to A to B first, or either we can go for the horizontal dimension. So let us see the horizontal dimension. So AD is 4 meter. So AD is, this is 4, 2 plus 2, 4 meter is there. So let us see this. 1, 2, 3 and 4 meter is there. Go to escape. Okay. Now, we got the point. So, consider the this point, then go to the translation repeat. Okay, in y direction, let us see what is the vertical dimension. This vertical dimension is, I have considered 5 meter. So here we have to consider number of step is 1, default spacing is 5 meter. Link the step, then go to okay. So this is 5 meter is okay. Then again click on the nodal point, then we have to go to x direction, because x is horizontal. So what was the spacing of x direction? This is 4 meter. So define the spacing as 4 meter horizontally, link the space, then okay. So this is like this. Then we have to move downward. Okay, so in y direction we have to move downward, therefore the spacing here, the spacing must be in minus. Okay, so it will be minus 3. Link the space, then it is okay, like this. Okay, now this is the additional point. You can delete this part. Okay, so just go to the beam cursor, select the beam cursor, then delete. This will be deleted. Okay, now our structure is completed. Okay, now we have to define the properties. Okay, so first of all we have to define the support property. Both are the fixed support. So we have to define the support conditions here in STAD. Okay, go to the node cursor, select the respective nodes of the support, then go to the command, go to the support specification. There are n number of options are available. Go to the fix, then assign, then close. So this is the fix symbol. You can see that. Okay, we have assigned the two supports. Now next step is define the property. As we have considered, all the members is having the uniform I section. So let us consider the B and D property, that is width and depth of the section, B as 0.23 and D as 0.45. okay, by default. So we have to define the property. Okay, so just click the beam cursor, select the beam cursor of all the members, then go to the command, go to the member property, prismatic, then here go to the rectangular. YD is the depth required, so we can define as 0.45. ZD is the width required, so we can go for 0.23. material is concrete, then assign, then close. Okay, assign, close, and then close. So if you see that this is the property is form, you can also see this property in 3D rendering. Okay, this is like, this is your model. Okay, you can go for the 3D rendering also. In 3D rendering you can go for, you can see the three dimensional view of the structure. Okay, then what we have to do now, we have to define the external support. So there are, sorry, external loads. So there are two loads here. First is gravity load in the form of W, which is having the intensity of 10 kN, and the horizontal load of P is there at point B, okay, which is the intensity of 5 kN. So let us define the load property. So here go to the general, go to load and definition, then go to load case, then go for add. Here define the load as live load. Okay, then here you have to define the live load here also. Case number one is there, load number, then add, then close. Now under live load we have to define the properties, then click on live load, go to add. Okay, so first of all we can define the nodal load. So nodal load, this is a very important part. Okay, so let us see where is nodal load. This is point P is there, which is having the intensity of 5 kN acting at point B. Okay, so we have to define the load in this is the x direction. So we have to define that force of kilonewton, 5 kilonewton plus 5 kilonewton in x direction. Okay, so we have to define this. Okay, then okay, now he is asking for where we have to put this 5 kilonewton. Okay, so just select the node cursor, click on the point where you required the horizontal force, then click on the respective selected load, go to the assign to the selected node, then assign. Okay, so this load is defined on the particular point. Now next is our gravity load. Okay, so for this, select this point BC. Okay, then under the live load, go to the add point, then this is nothing but a member load. Okay, and we have to provide the member load. What was the intensity of member load? It is the 10 kilonewton. Okay, so we have to define minus of 10 kilonewton. Okay, so let us define the distance as 2 meter. So like this, 2 meter we have defined this. Okay, you just go to assign to selected beam, assign and close. Okay, okay, but it is a uniform loads, I think. So we have committed the mistake. Just go to delete. Again, consider the live load. Go to the add load case. Then here, go to the member load. Okay, area load, floor load. You go to the member load. Is in kilonewton meter. Uniform concentrated load. Yes, concentrated load we have to define, and the concentrated load was 10 kilonewton. So we have to define minus 10 kilonewton. Okay, the D1 distance is 2 meter. Okay, then assign. So let us select the required member where the load is to be defined. This is point BC, member BC. Then go to the select the load, go to the assign beam, then assign this like this. Now we have defined the load property on a model. Okay, so if you see that we have defined all the parameters in our structure. Okay, now consider the structure, select the structure, go to the command, go to the analysis, go to perform analysis, click on all. Okay, then go to analysis, run analysis, save. So let us see. So here no errors, zero error, zero warning is formed. That means our answer or our analysis is okay. Then go to the post processing, done. Here it is asking for the selected loads. We have to consider the selected load as live load, apply. Okay, so this is our case for live load. Okay, now let us see the final BMD diagrams. First of all, go to the labels, click on none, apply and okay, so that the dimensions cannot be written matter cannot be seen. Okay, now we are interested in bending moments, so by default whenever you go for the post processing, it will show you the deflection property. So we are interested in bending moment, so go for the MZ. Okay, then click on control. Okay, and slightly move the cursor so that you will get the final output. So this is our final diagram. Okay, so as we know that both are the fixed support, so therefore the moment were formed on either support. Okay, so let us see the results, view the values, beam results. Okay, we are interested in bending end moments. Okay, then anode, we will see this. So this is our final output. Okay, so this is 1.16 8 kilonewton. This is minus 7.3. This is 7.2, 7.2, and this is 0.6, I think, kilonewton meter. Okay, like this. Again, go to result, go to view. Now, let us see for shear force. So, shear will be okay. We have to select this structure first. Go to the results, go to views. Beam property, then select the shear property. Okay, so for this case we have to consider the shear force in FY direction. This is the shear force. So this is the shear force diagram, like this. Okay, so by this method, by this way you can easily model your numerical in StatPro, and you can get the final output in the form of shear force and bending moment. Okay, and you have to verify this values with respect to your manual calculation. So it is very easy to model n number of numericals in STAT, and you can get the final output in the form of bending moment and shear force. Okay, so I have solved this numerical for you as a practical number 3. Okay, so you are expected to solve your numerical as per your roll number, okay, and as per the various criteria given as per this table. Also, I have solved one basic value of D for the different value of I. Suppose a roll number 10 to 18 is having the different value of I, that is BC I of span of BC of I is equal to 1.25. So in that case, you have to calculate the span of BC as 1.25. So therefore, we have to consider this. We have to put the value of I of BC is 0.48. Okay. So here, BA and CD is II. So here, in this case, you have to put the value of BC, that is D factor. Here, when you model the structure in STAD and while defining the property of the member BC, so in that case you have to put the value of D as 0.48 in case of BC. Okay, while rest of the thing, that is B factor is 0.23, will be same, and here B and CD, the B and D factor will be 0.23 by 0.45, whereas for BC only the D factor is 0.48, because as the value of I for span BC is 1.25. Okay, so here you have to be very careful while defining the property of BC in the form of D. Okay, so it is expected from your side that you have to solve this numerical as a manually, and you have to submit this numerical, okay, in the Google Classroom under the practical submission folder. Okay, and whatever the output you will get in the form of bending moment and shear force, and then you have to compare this value with STAT value. Okay, so this is your practical number 3. Okay, you have to solve this and you have to submit this one. Okay, I think I have not cover the practical number 2 for this case. So it is very very similar to the practical number 1, as methods are same for as a moment distribution is applicable for practical number 2 also, and we have already seen the practical number 1 by using moment distribution for different I value and for single Y value. So by following this same step, you can solve this practical number 2. Okay, and after that you have to solve this practical number 3 by using Carney's method. So in this case you have to solve the numerical manually by using Carney's method that we have already completed in our theoretical part. Okay, so with reference to that you can solve this numerical, and after solving you will get the bending moment and shear force, and you have to compare this bending and shear force by modeling this structure in STAAD, and you will get the final value in the form of STAAD and in the form of bending moment and shear force. Okay, and then finally you have to make a table and put the values of bending moment and shear force, okay, by using both the methods, manually and STAAD. Okay, so we will see more variety of this numerical or the next practical in our next lecture. Okay, so thank you for your kind attention. Thank you.